We went and covered up the tourists that died, God rest their souls, and waited, terrified, in complete chaos.
These are the pictures Abdul Ali Ladhari took as he and his friends waited for police to come. They tried, he says, to give the victims back their dignity, to shield them as best they could.
He said he have a gun, help us.
This was the first shout Ladhari said he heard. He watched as the woman fell to the ground. Ladhari works at a beach shack renting jet skis and parachute rides to tourists. The day Saif al-Din al-Rizqi opened fire on the beach had been like any other. Until, of course, it wasn't.
When we men ran towards him, he said, "I don't have any issue with Arabs. My targets are the Europeans."
So when you heard this, I asked, did you keep coming?
We moved quicker. We couldn't leave him. Yes, we were scared, terrified, but we couldn't back off.
Many of the European tourists caught in the chaos that day have spoken about the bravery of local Tunisians. In this amateur footage, you can hear the cameraman and others rushing against all instinct towards the shooter, desperate to stop the rampage. But of course, they couldn't. Ladhari says for many of the victims that day, all he could do was keep them company in their last moments. One British grandfather died in his arms.
My wife dead.
He asked me, "Is my wife dead?" I checked her pulse. I said, "Yes, she is." He did this, thank you God, and cried and died. I can't say anything more. He thanked God that she hadn't suffered.
Like that. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. And cry, and dead.
He shows us where the killer jammed the butt of the machine gun as Ladhari says he tried to protect them. As he lay on the ground, he tells us he watched as a little boy was shot at point-blank range. The shock, the horror. Speaking to Ladhari, you can see it hasn't left him. I asked if he ever found out the name of the British man who died in his arms. No. As people around the world struggle to understand why, Ladhari says he wishes he had answers.
He killed them, he destroyed them, and he destroyed us with them.
Nima Elbaghir, CNN, Sousse.